सो गाइस, आज हम पढ़ने जा रहे हैं थर्मोडायनामिक्स का बहुत ही इम्पोर्टेंट लेक्चर, जिसमें हम डिस्कस करने जा रहे हैं हीट ऑफ न्यूट्रलाइजेशन। ये बहुत ही ज़्यादा इम्पोर्टेंट है। मोस्ट फ्रीक्वेंटली क्वेश्चंस आर आस्क्ड फ्रॉम दिस कंसेप्ट। सो आवर टॉपिक इज हीट ऑफ न्यूट्रलाइजेशन, हीट और एंथैल्पी, एंथैल्पी ऑफ न्यूट्रलाइजेशन, एंथैल्पी ऑफ न्यूट्रलाइजेशन, एंथैल्पी ऑफ न्यूट्रलाइजेशन। दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक फॉर योर कम्पिटिटिव एग्जाम्स। बहुत ही ज़्यादा इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक है। तो डिस्कस करने जा रहे हैं एंथैल्पी ऑफ न्यूट्रलाइजेशन, और उसके बाद ये दो तीन क्वेश्चंस हैं जो हम सॉल्व करने जा रहे हैं। एंथैल्पी ऑफ न्यूट्रलाइजेशन क्या होता है? व्हाट इज न्यूट्रलाइजेशन? न्यूट्रलाइजेशन इज एक्चुअली रिएक्शन ऑफ एसिड एंड बेस, एसिड प्लस बेस। Whenever acid and base react, they form salt and they give water. This is actually neutralization. Now, how much amount of heat is required in this process? When 1 gram equivalent of an acid is completely neutralized by 1 gram equivalent of base, the amount of heat involved is known as enthalpy or heat of neutralization. So, first we will go to the definition. तो इसकी डेफिनेशन ये होगी, व्हेन 1 ग्राम इक्विवेलेंट ऑफ एसिड रिएक्ट्स विद 1 ग्राम इक्विवेलेंट ऑफ बेस, जो अमाउंट ऑफ हीट इन्वॉल्व होगी दैट विल बी नोन एज एंथैल्पी ऑफ न्यूट्रलाइजेशन और हीट ऑफ न्यूट्रलाइजेशन। द अमाउंट ऑफ हीट रिलीज्ड इट्स एन एक्सोथर्मिक प्रोसेस, दैट्स व्हाई आई राइट हियर अमाउंट ऑफ हीट रिलीज्ड when 1 gram equivalent of an acid is completely neutralized by 1 gram equivalent of a base in dilute solution. This is the definition of enthalpy of neutralization. When 1 gram equivalent of an acid is completely neutralized by 1 gram equivalent of the base to form salt, the amount of heat released in this process, that is known as enthalpy or heat of neutralization. बहुत ही ज़्यादा important होने जा रहा है ये टॉपिक, बहुत ही ज़्यादा इम्पोर्टेंट होने जा रहा है। नाउ एक्सपेरिमेंटली इट हैज़ बीन फाउंड दैट व्हेन 1 ग्राम इक्विवेलेंट ऑफ स्ट्रॉन्ग एसिड एंड 1 ग्राम इक्विवेलेंट ऑफ स्ट्रॉन्ग बेस न्यूट्रलाइज्ड टू फॉर्म साल्ट, द अमाउंट ऑफ हीट रिलीज्ड इज इक्वल टू -13.7 किलो कैलोरीज पर मोल। व्हेन 1 ग्राम इक्विवेलेंट ऑफ स्ट्रॉन्ग एसिड and strong base are completely neutralized, strong acid and strong base, the amount of heat released is -13.7 kilocalories per mole. Let us take a strong acid, we have HCl, it is a strong acid. Let us take a strong base, we have NaOH, it is a strong base. They combine together, they form salt NaCl and they give water. Now, how much amount of heat is released? This is a strong acid, this is a strong base. Experimentally, it has been found that delta H of neutralization of this reaction is everywhere where strong acid and strong base combine, it is always equal to delta H neutralization will be equal to -13.7 kilocalories per mole. Now, it's always equal to -13.7 kilocalories per mole, because strong acid completely dissociated, strong base completely ionized, therefore it will be equal to neutralization of water. Neutralization of water is H positive plus OH negative ions, they give H2O. This reaction involves -13.7 kilocalories per mole of heat, that's why for strong acid and strong base, it's equal to -13.7. Therefore, we can here conclude that enthalpy of neutralization of strong acid and strong base is actually the ionization of water. Actually, the enthalpy change involved in the ionization, involved in the formation of water from its ions. Now this is the case of strong acid and strong base, we always get this. Now how can we conclude that which acids are strong acids and which are strong bases? So many both बहुत बार ये कहा है क्लास में कि ग्रुप फर्स्ट और ग्रुप सेकंड एलिमेंट्स जो होते हैं ग्रुप फर्स्ट एंड ग्रुप सेकंड, ग्रुप फर्स्ट एलिमेंट्स एंड ग्रुप सेकंड एलिमेंट्स जो भी इनके हाइड्रोक्साइड्स होते हैं वो स्ट्रांग बेसिस होते हैं, लिथियम, सोडियम, पोटेशियम, रुबिडियम, सीजियम, कैल्शियम, मैग्नीशियम, कैल्शियम, बेरियम, रेडियम, दे ऑल फॉर्म hydroxides, all their hydroxides are strong bases, except these, whatever hydroxides we are, they are usually weak bases, these are the strong bases. Now if you have to remember what are strong, which species are strong bases, these are group first and group second hydroxides, they are strong bases. Now whenever a strong base and strong acid reacts, they form salt. Every wire where we have strong acid and strong base, if their neutralization is carried out, amount of heat of neutralization or enthalpy of neutralization is -13.7 kilocalories per mole. Now this is the definition, but how can we solve questions from this? We can have sometimes weak acid and strong base, or we have four types of salts: salt of strong acid, strong base. We can have salt of strong acid, weak base, salt of weak acid, strong base. We can have weak acid, weak base salt. Now in this case we know that the amount of enthalpy of neutralization is -13.7 kilocalories per mole. It's actually formation of water from its ions because they 100% dissociate, ionize. But in all these cases what will happen? The enthalpy of neutralization, delta H of neutralization, will be less than -13.7 kilocalories per mole. Now why it is less than -13.7? See in this case what happens, let us take weak acid or strong acid and weak base. This is our strong acid HCl, we take weak base ammonium hydroxide. This is a weak base because this is not a base of group first and group second. Now see, they give ammonium chloride as salt plus they give water. Now in this case delta H of neutralization will not be equal to -13.7, it will be less than -13.7, it's -12.4 something, approximately -12.4 kilocalories per mole, means the enthalpy of neutralization is less. Why the enthalpy of neutralization decreases? Now see, this is a weak base, it does not ionize completely, ionizes completely. Therefore, some amount of heat is required to ionize this. Some amount of heat means from 13.7 kilocalories per mole, some amount of heat is required to ionize this, to ionize ammonium hydroxide, weak base or weak acid. That's why enthalpy of neutralization decreases. The only exception to this case is when we have HF. HF is our weak acid, it's a weak acid. When we treat it with sodium hydroxide. Now this is the exception. This is only exception. It has its own reasons. Now in this case, what we get? NaF plus water. Now in this case, delta H of neutralization should have been less than 13.7, but it is -18.5. Now why the enthalpy of neutralization in this case is more? It is because HF undergoes hydrogen bonding with water molecules. There is possibility of hydrogen bonding between HF-HF molecules and between HF and water molecules. Because of that hydrogen bonding, certain amount of energy is required for solvation. That's why enthalpy of neutralization increases. This is the only exception. This is very important. Now what type of questions are asked from this enthalpy of neutralization? How can we solve questions based upon enthalpy of neutralization? Now first type of question, that is the conceptual based question, that may be asked like this. See, the question will be, the enthalpy of question number 1 will be like this. Given the enthalpy of delta H of neutralization of acid, enthalpy of neutralization of acid and base is -11.3 kilojoules kilocalories per mole. Now which of the following represents that acid and base? Number first is HCl plus NaOH. Number second answer will be our HCl plus magnesium hydroxide. Number third will be our for example H2SO4, this is a strong acid, plus NaOH. And number fourth will be like this, we can have acetic acid CH3COOH plus NaOH. Now see, since the heat of neutralization is less than -13.7, therefore this indicates that it is not salt of strong acid and strong base. Now this is strong acid, strong base, its enthalpy of neutralization should be -13.7, therefore this is not answer. This is strong acid, this is strong base, it is not correct. This is strong acid, strong base, not correct. This is weak acid, some amount of heat is required to dissociate this acid, ionize this acid, therefore its value will be less than -13.7. this will be the correct answer. This is question from conceptual point of view. Now one more type of question that will be asked from conceptual point of view. We are given three species, three acids, X, Y and Z, three compounds, X, Y and Z. Now enthalpy of neutralization for this is delta HN of neutralization for this is -13.7, and for this is minus delta HN neutralization for the formation of this salt is -9.7. And for this is delta H of neutralization is -11.5. Arrange them in the order of increasing strength, acid strength, which one will be more strength. Arrange increasing order of acid strength. Increasing order of acid strength. Now see, more the amount of enthalpy of neutralization, more will be the acidic strength. Means acid strength, acidic nature, acidic strength is directly proportional to strength of acidic strength is directly proportional to delta H of neutralization. Now greater the value of delta H of neutralization, more stronger will be the acid. Now in this case the value is greater, therefore X is our more stronger acid, then Z, then Y. These are conceptual based questions which may be asked. Now let us move to problem based questions that can be asked from enthalpy of neutralization. Now question number one is 0.5 moles of HCl is neutralized by 0.5 mole of NaOH. Question number 1 is, when 0.5 mole of HCl is neutralized with 0.5 mole of NaOH, now how much amount of heat is released? This will give NaCl plus water. Now see, in this case what happens? We have HCl and we have NaOH, they react together, they form NaCl and they form water. Now this is our strong acid, this is our strong base. In this case delta H of neutralization should be -13.7 kilocalories per mole. If you calculate in terms of kilojoules, then it comes out to be -50.3. now see, we are here given, let at time t is equal to 0, we will approach the problem in a different way first. Let at time t is equal to 0, its concentration is 1. Its concentration is 1, so the concentration of salt is 0. Let after a time, after a certain time, t is equal to t seconds, sum of it has been decomposed, that's x, 1 minus x, then x is formed. Since it is completely neutralized, how much amount we are given? 0.5 has reactors. Out of 1, 0.5 reactors. Therefore, it remains 1 minus 0.5. This remains 1 minus 0.5, and this is formed 0.5. 1 minus 0.5 is 0.5, it is 0.5. Now the amount of heat released is -13.7 kilocalories per mole. Now this is for 1 mole or 1 gram equivalent, it is this, but we are reacting only 0.5. We can approach the problem like this. For 1 gram equivalent of acid and base, delta H of neutralization is equal to -13.7 kilocalories per mole. Now for 0.5 gram equivalents or moles, it's equal to -13.7 into 0.5. For 3 gram equivalents or 3 moles, -13.7 into 3. for 4 minus 13.7 into 4. Therefore, value comes out to be minus 13.7 into 5 by 10. Now, solving this, you can get the answer. You have to solve this, you will get the answer. Now, question number 2 is, we will use concept of limiting reagent over here. I will tell you a simple trick how you will approach question number 2. Now see, we have HNO3, a strong acid. If we treat it with NaOH, a strong base, we get salt NaCl plus we get water. In this case, delta H of neutralization will be minus 13.7. This is experimental, K calories per mole. Now see, how many moles of nitric acid we have? 0.30. How many moles of NaOH? 0.50. Now use the concept directly, you without solving this, directly use the concept of limiting reagent. This is present in small quantity, use is at limiting reagent. Use this as limiting reagent. Therefore, determine the number heat of neutralization for only 0.30 moles. Therefore, for 1 mole, it's equal to minus 13.7 kilocalories per mole. For 0.30 moles, this will be equal to minus 13.7 into 0.30 kilocalories per mole. Now this is very simple trick. Whichever is present in small quantity, take that one. Now this will be equal to minus 13.7 into 30 divided by 100. Now you can solve this. You will get heat of neutralization of this reaction. Now let us move to the question number 3. This question has been asked and is asked. Questions are being asked like this. 100 ml of, we have HCl. We mix it with NaOH. We get NaCl and we get water. Now see what is given. 100 ml of 0.2 moles. 0.2 molar HCl. And we are given 100 ml of 0.3 molar HCl. Now we have to determine heat of formation. First we will determine its molar, its number of, first we will determine this, what is 100 ml of 0.2 molar HCl and what is 100 ml of 0.3 molar HCl. We have seen from solutions, from molarity, normality, we have seen, since HCl is a monobasic acid, therefore we can do, what is this, 0.2 moles. This is 0.2 divided by 1000 into 100 divided by 1000 into 100. Here we will get number of moles. How much moles? This is moles of HCl. Moles of HCl. We can determine, we know that molarity is equal to number of moles divided by volume of solution in liters. From this we can determine it. Or we can determine number of moles, weight in grams of substance divided by molecular mass into 1000 divided by volume of solution in mLs. Now see, this and this will cut. It will be 0.2 divided by 10. Now what is 0.2 divided by 10? It is 0.02. This is 0.02. 0.2 divided by 10 is 0.02. Now take this, number of moles is equal to number of moles of NaOH will be equal to 0.3 into 100 divided by 1000. Now two zeros and two zeros will cancel, we will get 0.03. Now take this reaction, HCl plus NaOH gives NaCl plus water. Now see here, in this case we have 0.02 moles, we have 0.03 moles. Now apply the concept of limiting reagent. This is present in small amount, therefore 1 mole of salt gives minus 13.7 kilocalories per mole. Now in this case, how many moles? 0.02 moles gives minus 13.7 into 0.02. Now solve this question. 13.7 into 2 divided by 100. Now get the answer. This is the trick how you can apply this trick to solve number of questions based upon heat of neutralization. What? Applying concept of limiting reagent. The small one is taken and the number of whose number of moles are smaller is to be multiplied with this. Now this is heat of neutralization and these are the questions which are usually asked on the heat of neutralization. This is very important from your JEE main and entrance exam point of view. Thank you for watching. If you like my videos, if you are getting something from my channel, then please do subscribe the channel. Thanks for watching.